Hello everyone, myself Rohith, Assistant Professor in Department of Mechanical Engineering, ATME, Mysuru. So I am here to explain the experiment by name Torsional Vibration. The main aim of this experiment is to study the undamped vibrations of a single rotor disc and also the time period and the natural frequency of the system. Here, a rotor disc, a circular disc which is connected to a shaft, we will be varying the shaft length and we will be finding the natural frequency of that shaft. So here, for the calculation, we will be taking a shaft length, we will be varying the shaft length, and also by varying the shaft length, we will be finding the oscillations. Number of oscillations will be fixed for 5 or 10 oscillations will be fixed. So for our sake, we will be used for the 5 oscillations will be fixed. Then, we will be calculating the time. Means time taken to complete that 5 oscillation.
How much seconds in time? In seconds that will be noted down in this time in oscillation, n oscillations. And finally we will be calculating the experimental time period. Experimental time period is the ratio of time taken to complete t oscillation by number of oscillation n. Means t divided by n. The value of t in seconds divided by number of oscillation, that is 5. So it gives you the time experimental theory, time period of experimental, that is t experimental, t by n in seconds. Next we have to calculate the theoretical time period. After completion of the experimental time period, we have to calculate the theoretical time period. To calculate the theoretical time period, we have 2 pi root of m by kt. 2 pi root of m by kt, where m is the mass moment of inertia and kt is the torsional stiffness value, that is in terms of seconds. To calculate the torsional stiffness value, we have a formula, that is gj by l. G is the modulus of rigidity, j is the polar moment of inertia, l is the length which is varied for each trial, and m, mass moment of inertia, that is half m r square. M is the mass of the rotor disc and the radius of the rotor disc r, that is in terms of kg meter square. Means mass will be in terms of kg and radius will be in terms of meter. So if, since it is a square, we will be expressed in terms of meter square. Then polar moment of inertia j, j is by pi d power by 32. Why we are using pi d power by 32? Because the shaft is a circular. So the circular, the polar moment of a circular rod will be taken as a pi d to the power of 4 by 32. So this value will be substituted over here and we will find the value of kt and this value of m, and finally we will be calculating the t theoretical, that is time theoretical, that in terms of seconds. Now we have been calculating the experimental time period and the theoretical time period. Next we will be finding the natural frequency of that particular shaft. How to find the natural frequency? It is the reciprocal of the time period. So, theoretical experimental natural frequency. To calculate the experimental natural frequency, reciprocal of time period of experimental. That is 1 divided by experimental. What is the value we'll be getting by t by n? That is 1 divided by t experimental gives you the natural frequency of experimental. Similarly, natural frequency of theoretical will be calculated by 1 divided by t theoretical. The t theoretical value which is obtained by in this formula and 1 divided by this value in terms of hertz. The frequency will be expressed in terms of hertz, and finally we will be calculating the percentage difference, means f theoretical minus f experimental divided by f theoretical into 100 gives you the some percentage of the difference. This is the equipment which we will be using, a torsional vibration. So this is a rotor disc and this is a shaft which is connected to a rotor disc, and one end of the shaft is connected to a movable jaw. Okay, movable jaw, and this is a chuck where we fix it in this position. So here there is a disc which is rotating and the shaft is connected. So I will be fixing the length of the shaft for 50 mm difference. That is, one is for 200, 250 and 300 mm. So first we have to make sure that it has been loosed. So it will be moved, and by taking a scale, we will be measuring the length of that, length of this, and I will be marking that 200 mm, 250 mm and a 300 mm. So I have been marked with a different length, and now I will be finding the time period of this each length. So now I will be taking to the chuck to the 200 mm, then I will be fixing this clamp. It should not move, it should not move, so that the this one is also been tightened. This one also be tightened. Make sure that it has been tightened with these keys. Make sure that this rotor disc is not freely moving. So that when it is moving, now we have fixed it for 200 mm. Okay. Now I am going to calculate the time period, experimental time period. How to calculate the experimental time period? As I said in the theory, we have to take a stopwatch, okay, and we have to just tap on this disc, and we have to make sure that for 5 oscillation, we have to count to 5 oscillation, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and time taken to complete that oscillation. So now I will be taking the tapping this one. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 1.15. 1.15 is the time taken to complete that in length 200. Now by varying the lengths 200 to 250 to 300, we will be taking the values and calculating the time period, and also the natural frequencies, and also the theoretical value, and comparing that theoretical and a natural